In this session, we will be discussing advanced traffic management with cloud load balancing and Envoy. My name is Andres Guedez. I am a load balancing tech lead at Google Cloud. I am here today with Hesham, Mekky, a software engineer at Snapchat who will be sharing their journey leveraging Envoy to transform Snapchat's traffic serving architecture.
Hello, everyone. I'm Hesham. I'm a software engineer in the infrastructure team at Snapchat.
Thanks so much for joining us today, Hesham. To start, I want to provide a brief overview of the cloud load balancing product portfolio offered by Google Cloud. We have a family of Layer 4 and Layer 7 load balancers. This session will be focused on the Layer 7 load balancing fleet and some new additions that we'll be discussing. There are two primary reasons customers use Google Cloud load balancers. First, traditional traffic management, distributing load and performing health checks to optimize traffic between clients and backends and ensure reliable delivery. The second reason is to use load balancers as a hub of value-added networking products, such as by integrating with Cloud CDN for web acceleration, IP and IAM for authentication and authorization, and CloudArmor for security policies. Focusing on the Layer 7 load balancing portfolio, we are introducing two new products. First, a regional external load balancer, which supports proxying of HTTP and HTTPS traffic to backends hosted on Compute Engine and GKE. Second, a next-generation global external load balancer with new capabilities. Our Layer 7 load balancers are now converged on Envoy Proxy, a CNCF open source project, providing a common data plane and feature set. Leveraging Envoy, these external load balancers provide new traffic management capabilities, such as advanced routing and traffic policies, so you can steer traffic with the flexibility required for complex workloads. In addition, we added support for hybrid load balancing. This topic will be further discussed in the next session. A few examples of the advanced traffic management capabilities are request mirroring for use cases such as out-of-path feature validation, weighted traffic splitting for use cases such as canary testing, new load balancing algorithms, and fault injection enabling reliability enhancing validation such as chaos testing. This is just an initial set of features. We'll be adding many more capabilities in the future. These new load balancers leverage Traffic Director infrastructure to provide a config and control plane using the XCS protocol pioneered by Envoy Proxy. Together with existing solutions such as the Traffic Director product, which provides a config plane for customer-managed proxies and gRPC proxyless clients, these new load balancers provide a standardized feature set enabling uniform capabilities, uniform policy management, and uniform observability. An example of this unified feature set can be found in this slide, where a customer leverages weighted backend services across global and regional external load balancers, internal load balancers, as well as on-premise through Traffic Director to enable canary testing of a new version of the customer's distributed application. By incrementally varying the weights, the customer is able to safely deploy a new feature or version of the application in a coordinated manner across all load balancing use cases for their architecture. Next, I will hand off the session to Hesham, who will present on Snapchat's journey from a monolithic application to microservices by leveraging Envoy.
Thanks, Andres. So I'm going to be talking to you about our journey from a monolith to a microservices. So Snapchat started as a monolith app running in Google App Engine. And this has allowed us to basically reach millions of users very quickly and iterate over our product features very quickly. However, as the scale grew, scaling the infrastructure and scaling the team became very challenging. Changing data models became very difficult because of the dependencies between different services in the same data store. So what we wanted is that we wanted basically teams to be able to iterate quickly over their own products and be able to independently make decisions on how they want their data to be stored. So we decided to move to a service-oriented architecture. So basically using a service-oriented architecture, we can solve these problems and enable our teams to have like independently deployable services, also known as microservices. And this way they can iterate over their products and test new features very quickly without having to have any friction in the monolith app. So what we wanted from the service-oriented architecture is a few properties. So we wanted to basically have security by default. What that means is we wanted services to be able to communicate with each other in different regions or in different cloud providers without having to have any security configuration if possible. So they should get secure communication by default. We also wanted to abstract away all of the networking infrastructure, like how actually these services reach each other, all of that traffic management and service discovery. So we wanted to abstract away all of that networking logic away as well and maintain that in the infra team while still giving the teams their own control over their kind of like products and features and how they want to architect them. We also wanted service owners to be able to create new services very quickly without high friction. So basically, we wanted them to be able to quickly create a new service, test a new product, and then don't have to spend like a lot of time figuring out how to set up their infrastructure. So at that point, we started to explore how we wanted to encapsulate this security and networking logic. And we looked at building this as a library or building this inside a proxy. And at that point, we decided to take Envoy as our like Envoy as our proxy, service proxy, and as our edge proxy. So few compelling features and important features that actually attracted us in Envoy. So one of them is the advanced traffic management that Envoy offers. And the other key feature is the XDS APIs that provides a clean separation between the data plane elements that's doing forwarding and routing and the control plane where all the logic of service discovery and other traffic management configs gets pushed to these data plane elements. So we started by building an internal console we call switchboard. So switchboard is started as our internal console for service management, where service owners can go to switchboard, create a new service in a very clean and simple UI console. They can configure some of the Envoy configurations, but in the UI instead of using actual YAML configs, for example. So you could do retries, they could do circuit breaking or traffic splitting, they could do interact with the console very quickly and manage their services. They can also create external routes to the client and configure the security policy they want on this external route that's reachable from our mobile app. Switchboard quickly evolved into like more than just service management. So we added deployments later on, and we added a lot of other features that basically address the friction that I was talking about, that setting up a new service should be very, very simple. And that's what Switchboard allows us to achieve. So this picture shows you a high level architecture of what our infrastructure looks like. So as I mentioned earlier, our users interact with Switchboard and then they configure what they want to do with the traffic or security for their service. And then Switchboard deploys these configs to our global data store, where the XDS servers that's running in a multi-region and multi-cloud can actually fetch these configs and then update the Envoy sidecars with the new configurations. Switchboard also allows us to gradually roll out these configs. So service owners, for example, could say that they want to roll out this new config 10% at a time and let every 10% bake for X number of minutes. And then once the sidecar gets these new configs, it starts reaching to other services and start enforcing these networking and security configurations. So from this picture, you can see, for example, for friends to use user service, to reach user service, all they need to do is to say users.snap, and all of the networking infrastructure is set up such that they can reach user service if it's located in the same region, or it can reach user service in the closest region where it's deployed. And all of that is abstracted away from the service owner. So this is kind of like how the internal service mesh work from an external client point of view, from the mobile app point of view. So our mobile app uses the Google load balancer, the global Google load balancer, to terminate connections to the closest Google edge using Anycast and using the Quick protocol, which provide us a very low latency to set up these connections and to the edge servers. And then the global Google load balancer reaches to our internal API gateway, our edge proxy, that's also powered by Envoy. And it starts to enforce the external route policy and security policy, basically, that's configured for that route in Switchboard, and then starts routing the traffic to the target service. So now that the global Google load balancer is also powered by the same XDS protocol that powers our API gateway, this opens up a lot of opportunities for us to basically rethink some of the functionality, like, for example, how we can use the common protocol to deliver configs to both of them and manage both of them using a central control plane. So we have written about our journey from monolith to microservices on a public blog post, so please take a look. And thank you. Back to Andres.
Thanks so much, Hesham, for sharing how Snapchat used Envoy and Google Cloud technologies to modernize your architecture. Before we wrap up our segment on advanced traffic management with cloud balancing and Envoy, I wanted to take a moment to discuss some of the unique capabilities of our new regional external load balancer. Like the other load balancers we have discussed, it is also based on Envoy, so it enables the same advanced traffic control capabilities we covered and can integrate well into a service mesh or distributed architecture. One additional thing to point out is that the regional external load balancer is built to support workloads that require jurisdictional compliance. We have many customers asking us which cloud products they should use if they have workloads with a specific requirements to keep data within a given region. The regional, external, and internal load balancers can help. Some of the properties provided by these load balancers are that data in transit stays in region. Traffic is terminated in the region where the regional external load balancer is configured. Regional backend services are enforced, and traffic stays in region as it is proxied to backends and is also encrypted in transit. Data at rest also stays in region. Certificates are residing region in transit and at rest. And lastly, the deployments of the regional load balancers are isolated from each other and from the global external HTTPS load balancer, as well as there's enhanced process isolation due to the use of single tenant proxies. Lastly, to recap the contents of this session, I wanted to revisit some of the key takeaways. First, Google Cloud load balancers now support advanced traffic capabilities for external and internal workloads. We are continuing our history of supporting open source and open standards through our contributions and use of Envoy Proxy. Envoy provides common features across multi-cloud and on-prem workloads. You can plan your own journey towards building distributed applications, as Snapchat has done. To learn more, we invite you to try our new load balancers or check out the following link. And next, I would like to introduce Bobby and Anton, who will be presenting on hybrid load balancing.